Last year, you told me there was approximately 30,000 animals on the border being lost on a yearly basis.
Basically multiplied by about 16.
Right.
What we call hotspots.
Right.
Which multiplies to about over 500,000 animals.
A year.
Animals a year.
Being taken.
But I must need. So here we have bone arrow snake poaching.
Mm-hmm.
The Maasai overgrazing. Here we have a little bit of everything. And here we have the livestock and army gangs. So basically it's
pressure from all sides.
It's pressure from all sides.
We've lost about 80% of the animals, certainly along the majority of the boundaries around the Tsavo.
Mm-hmm.
And what's left need protection.
To future generations. I mean, who do you think you are just coming in here and poaching away and killing away and being a pain? Here we have a human-wildlife conflict.
Mm-hmm.
And what we had before was a case where the people were saying, well, your animals are coming out eating our crops. Right. We have no choice but to rely on the park for our survival. So we said, okay, let's do this. Let's fence it. At least stop the animals coming onto your farms.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it didn't change.
Right.
It stopped the wildlife conflict onto them, but it didn't stop human conflict them onto the park.
Right.
So now we've eliminated one problem.
Right.
But we have to eliminate the other. So through the community initiative, we're now forming what we call human-wildlife conflict resolution committees.
Right.
They're now, through various outreach programs, basically getting them to do something about that problem themselves.